and historic Hollywood property is about to get a big restoration.
Gail Anderson live in Hollywood at what was known as the Earl Carroll Theatre, and apparently there's a lot of pressure on you now, Gail, to invoke morning news history.
Mm.
Well, here's a little hint. Think Aquarius Theater. We'll get back to that moment. But we're in the lobby here to show that you can see that some of this has survived. Where are we? Take a look at this. Most of you know the property as the Nickelodeon Theater on Sunset Boulevard, near Argyle. Bob Keith, you might as well come this way. They tell me there's no graphics. But the property people have driven by for years as the Nickelodeon, and before that, it was originally the Earl Carroll Theater.
Yes, and a lot of this interior is still with us.
I can't believe it. I haven't been in here since I don't want to give away Sam's deal, but we were in here for something special, and it looks great. I was worried.
No, Nickelodeon took great care of this place, and I'm absolutely amazed that the goddess of neon is still with us. Columns of neon still surround the bar.
Those columns behind us are still intact. They haven't been damaged.
I'm shocked. Really, my jaw is on the floor. The fact that I saw them glowing, surrounded by glass tubes and lucite, it's gorgeous.
And we want people to understand, although we can't show you now, we'll show you later, that this will be restored, and there will be an apartment complex, I'm told, added next door, again to blend in with the property. It won't be a high rise, and we'll show you the images later. Again, all of this will happen in about two and a half years, and the neon will be restored. But that's what you're worried about.
I was worried about the neon, and yes, bring that neon back to the streets of Sunset Boulevard, please.
All right, you can learn more about this by going to the LA Conservancy website or the Art Deco Society of Los Angeles website. Again, this project will be going on for 2.5 years. Okay, I don't want to give it away. Back to you, Sam.
Actually, I'll take it right here, and I am the king of neon. I love neon. If I could, I'd have it everywhere, but I get a boss that I have to answer to.
Look at this magnificent Art Deco in the lobby of the original Earl Carroll Theater here in Hollywood. This complex is about to undergo a major historic restoration. All of the Art Deco will be restored, the neon restored outside and in. We'll talk all about it and learn about Earl Carroll when we return.
A historic Hollywood property is about to get a big restoration.
Gail Anderson live at what was known as the Earl Carroll Theater. Gail, good morning.
We are in the magnificent lobby. We're so excited that so much of this still remains. Why? Because of this. Take a look. It's been home to lots of productions, including this, the Nickelodeon Studios recently. And it appears they have been great stewards of protecting what's here. But this is how it looked originally. The Earl Carroll Theater, not long after it was built in 1938. And we've got that music going from 1938 to give you a feel of what this was like. Here, take a look at a clip of a movie that Earl Carroll produced about his theater entitled A Night at the Earl Carroll Theater. Watch this.
Carroll's Theater Restaurant in Hollywood, but tonight it's a super special occasion with stars of stage and screen giving place to the bright lights of the political world as Mayor Jones of Hollywood plays host to the mayors of Southern California.
It was a big deal, and it will be a big deal again. Here's the artist's sketch of how this development will look when it's completed in a little more than 2 years. The theater will be here, plus an apartment complex next door. Richard Adkins, president of the Hollywood Heritage Historical Society. We've got some images here of Richard, of Earl Carroll. This Correct. Man was a businessman, an entrepreneur,
Absolutely.
A showman.
He was very much an entrepreneur and a showman. Started out as a writer-producer, began doing these shows. He was a contemporary of both Ziegfeld and George White. He had the nickname of being the Duke of Nude because his showgirls...
The Duke of...
Nude.
Oh, my.
Because his showgirls wore less than anybody else's. And that he had built a theater in New York that, unfortunately, he built it right at the beginning of the Depression and did do well. And Earl was smart enough. He'd already made a couple of movies based on the vanity. So he came to California and he established this nightclub, which initially started out as a membership club, but then became open to the public.
and celebrities. These are some of the glasses that had celebrity signatures on there that were duplicated on the Wall of Fame outside.
Right.
Those were concrete blocks, and Earl Carroll would have celebrities who came here sign the block, and then he would have an artist do it in paint, and then they would adhere it to the outside of the building.
Outstanding.
And you could buy these souvenir glasses with the same signatures on them here in the club.
All right, here's where you can read more about the restoration that's happening here, courtesy of the LA Conservancy, and as well as the Art Deco Society of Los Angeles. An outstanding project, and we're not done. We're going to take you inside to the theater, the only revolving theater of its kind. Next hour, the Earl Carroll Theater Restoration.
What interesting history, Gail. Thanks for
So exciting. We are inside the historic Earl Carroll Theater. You probably know it as the Nickelodeon Studio, or maybe you know it for the Chevy Chase Show, or maybe you even know it for our anniversary show here at one point. Well, it's about to undergo a major restoration and redevelopment. What's so important about this facility, in addition to its history, there was a revolving stage here. We're going to learn how they're going to restore it and remind you that it's the only type of revolving stage this side.
And a historic Hollywood property about to get a big restoration.
Gail Anderson live in Hollywood of what was known as the Earl Carroll Theater. Gail, good morning.
Good morning. I say that for a reason. We're inside the actual theater where I'm told as many as 1,000, maybe 1,500 people could have dinner and a show. Most of you know it for this. Take a look. Nickelodeon Studios was here at one time. It was also the Aquarius Theater. People saw hair there, hair here. Originally this, take a look, the Earl Carroll Theater. Neon outside and in. Now it's going to be restored. Here's how it's going to look. The theater will be restored outside and in, and then there will be an apartment complex next door. Scott Norton, LA Historic Theater Foundation representative, I've got to ask you, how did you create this relationship to make this happen? Because these kinds of developments are often challenging and difficult with developers.
I'd say it's very rare that the developers and preservationists sit at the same table. We actually had over 2 years of conversations. We developed a coalition with the Hollywood Heritage, LA Art Deco Society, the LA Conservancy, and the LA Historic Theater Foundation, and we were all at the table with the developer for over 2 years, working on how do we save this theater and make it part of their development.
Because this is a one of a kind.
It is.
And it's pretty big.
It's very one of a kind. 1,000 people could sit here and watch a show on a 60-foot diameter double turntable.
And let us show people what you mean by that. Behind you here, we have a photograph with Mr. Carroll in the middle of it, planning this revolving stage that you're telling us about. And now here is the actual footage of the stage moving from a movie Mr. Carroll produced entitled A Night at the Earl Carroll Theater. That's Mr. Carroll there talking. He put himself in his own movie. But here's some footage of all these women on the stage for a performance. And you tell me the stage is still here.
Yes.
There's the revolving stage. The weight, how do you engineer something to handle all that weight?
This was actually strong enough to hold 4 cars. So if you go down, it's still in the basement right now.
It's still here.
There's big concrete tracks, and this is how it looks today. All of this wood looks brand new, all the metal and concrete, it's still there. If we take off the studio floor that's on top of it right now,
mm-hmm.
I'd love to just flick that switch and see it turning again.
Well, in a couple of years, perhaps we will. I'm told this project will take about 2 years to complete.
Right, and part of what the Theater Foundation is going to do is work with a developer to get someone who actually wants to operate this as a theater. Mm-hmm. So what we'll be doing is looking around, find a producer who can actually make this stage, bring the stage to life. Let's get an audience in here, let's get some shows on the stage. That's what's going to bring this building to life.
And as you can see how tiny the people appear to be in here, this is quite a venue. I hope you'll let us follow the progress of this project.
Okay.
And